tongue tie is, it varies in size, but it's a piece of tissue underneath the tongue. It's an inelastic piece of tissue, and depending on how much of it is there, or how short it is, or how tight it is, it can actually almost glue the entire tongue to the floor of the mouth. So it can hugely restrict tongue function, and more importantly, tongue resting posture in the roof of the mouth, where that's growing the face and supporting everything above and different diaphragms below. So we're not meant to be tongue-tied. The restriction is called a frenulum, and it's got a very important function in utero from about 4 weeks for a number of weeks while the baby is developing. And it's just holding the tongue in position while other bones are beginning to develop. And once it does that, it's meant to completely dissolve in a process called apoptosis. So we are not meant to be born with any frenulum. When you mention a tongue tie, we think that the tongue is the only thing that can be tied down. But in fact, there are seven main tethered oral tissues. There is one on the top lip, we can find one on the bottom lip, we can find one under the tongue, and we can find one each on each of the four cheeks. So there are seven main TOTS that we refer to. TOTS, or tethered oral tissue. It was Dr. Kevin Boyd that suggested that acronym to be used, and you're going to hear that term quite a lot more now than maybe a tongue tie. If a tongue is restricted, it's a little bit like asking somebody to run a marathon with a rope around their legs. Because if the tongue can't work to 100% of its capacity, your face won't be supported and encouraged to grow to its full potential. You won't get correct swallowing. You won't get the correct upstream rocking off your cranium. You won't get the correct movement of the pituitary gland. You won't get the correct drainage of the lymphatic tissue in the back of the throat and your nose. You won't get the perimeter of the jaws developing to their full extent. So there are loads of consequences. Very recently, Dr. Christian Guimeneau has published yet another paper, one of over 600, I believe, but he has published another research paper stating that a short lingual frenulum, that if an individual has a short lingual frenulum, there is, or that particular phenotype, there is a 48% risk that they will have obstructive sleep apnea. Now, he's saying obstructive sleep apnea, which is at the end of a continuum. He's not saying a snoring problem or a sleep breathing problem. He is saying there's a 48% risk of obstructive sleep apnea. And that is huge. Why would you want to leave any tongue tie there? Well, it's not meant to be there anyway. It's meant to have dissolved by week 12 in utero. It's quite extraordinary, but we will see, at a conservative level, we will see at least 60% of the patients coming in with some form of TOT or other. So the research shows that possibly four, they'll all say four, but in some research, they'll push it to about 10% of the population would present with the tongue tie. And we're seeing far more people presenting with the tongue tie. So somewhere along the line, the environment is creating some kind of a change. Yeah, they generally are. And you mightn't believe it, but I was tongue-tied myself. And while I was apprehensive, I decided, no. If I'm advising people to get tongue-tie releases, I'm going to have my own tongue released just so I can at least share with anybody that came in to have it done, I could share my own experience. And it was a very easy procedure. It was videotaped at my own request, and it has been shared with a lot of dentists to try and help them. But I've been able to share my own experience with people. I was very sore day one. After that, I was fine. But you get people that can be sore for maybe 3 days. They mightn't be sore at all. Everybody is different. It's a very fast procedure. It can be revised using the surgical scalpel, and that's very fast. Or it can be revised using laser. It's a little bit slower because it's just a different type of procedure. But one way or another, both procedures are fast. And it's nothing really to be apprehensive about. We don't always find it, but we've had a number of immediate or instantaneous results or things that might have happened within a 24-hour period. We've had a lady that came in whose jaw was quite far back, that came forward by about 2 millimetres, which is significant. We've had people that immediately stopped snoring. We had a little boy in, he was 10, Down syndrome boy, and he was a bedwetter, and he stopped wetting the bed from that night when he went to bed. And very often it's just when that tongue is freed and it can get to where it's needed and get working again that a lot of these problems can stop. We had a lady who never ate meat because she always felt she would choke and felt she couldn't swallow properly, and she felt her swallowing improved hugely. And she was a lady in her 70s, and when I rang her up about 2 weeks later just to see how she was getting on, she said, "You won't believe it, but I've eaten chicken." And she had to wait 70 years to know what chicken tasted like. And I rang her up about maybe, because I was doing a little bit of research and wondering how people were getting on, and I rang her up about 3 months later, and she was at that point eating steak. So she had to wait all that time because she couldn't swallow properly because of the tongue tie.